Working in an anaerobic environment like the one we have on a Schlenk manifold and in a glove box means that oxygen dissolving liquids must be removed before we can use them. We've already done a video about sparging, which removes this dissolved oxygen through bubbling, but also resulting in significant evaporation. If you have a precious liquid that you can't afford to lose to evaporation or is too hazardous to risk exposure to fumes, then it's time to opt for freeze pump thaw. How does it work? We'll get that in a minute. To do freeze pump thaw, you'll need a flask with your liquid that can also be connected to a hose from a Schlenk manifold and a smaller dual fuel with liquid nitrogen. The liquid has not been prepared in any special way. Just pop open the bottle and pour it in. Safety note: skin exposure to liquid nitrogen or even the cold vapors could result in frostbite, so be careful when pouring or maneuvering the dewar. Mitch is using a Teflon stopper storage flask for this procedure, and he'll attach a hose adapter. Using silicone grease here is necessary for an airtight seal. Rubber bands are used to hold the pieces together. The flask is then mounted on a clamp and attached to a rubber hose in the Schlenk manifold. As you can see, we have three places that can be opened or closed to introduce vacuum into the system. Mitch has opened the front vacuum tab at the manifold, and the glass stopper on the hose adapter is also open. However, the Teflon stopper is still closed at this point. It is now time to begin the actual freeze pump thaw. First, the freeze. Your flask is carefully immersed in the liquid nitrogen. Make sure to avoid having the flask or clamp touch the dewar, as it is made of mirror glass and can be damaged easily. Monitor the level of liquid nitrogen as it will boil away as heat is removed from the liquid and the liquid solidifies. Add more liquid nitrogen as needed. Continue to try and peek into the flask. You need to be sure that the liquid inside is completely frozen before proceeding to the next step. Once you are sure there is no liquid left, go ahead and gently begin opening the Teflon stopper and introduce a vacuum into the flask. This is step number 2, pump. We have electronic vacuum gauges that we are using to monitor when the vacuum gap backs down to its lowest point and all the air has been removed from the flask. Once that has been done, the Teflon stopper is closed again. Mitch now raises the flask out of the liquid nitrogen, moves the dewar carefully out of the way, and then treats the flask like it was a small baby. Nothing but the best cork ring for the little one. With the flask closed, the final process is thaw. We are going to allow the flask to warm back up to room temperature. Considering it was around 77 Kelvin, this is going to take a little while. This is probably a good time to explain the theory behind how this works. You have successfully removed all of the air inside the flask without evaporating any of that precious liquid, but you still haven't really removed the dissolved gas. When that liquid froze, the dissolved gas became trapped inside, but you still have a vacuum inside the flask now even though the stopper has been closed. As the solid melts, you notice it will start to bubble. That's the dissolved gas being drawn up into the headspace of the flask and out of the liquid. Once the liquid has begun melting, it's probably safe to use a water bath to accelerate the melting process. Here, you can see just how many bubbles of dissolved gas were present in the liquid. You have successfully completed the first of three freeze pump thaw cycles. Begin your second cycle by freezing your liquid in the liquid nitrogen dewar once again. After three cycles, you have removed all dissolved gas and ready to go. Just a quick note though, if you're interested in bringing this liquid into the glove box, please let it warm completely so that there's no ice in the flask. Ice in the glove box would make Mitch so sad.